I have walked on Sinbad's yellow shore, and never shall another hit my fancy. Sligo, in the northwest of Ireland, was the source of William Butler Yeats's work, from the time of his boyhood visits to his mother's parents' home, Merville, now an old people's home. And when Yeats was not visiting Sligo, he was listening to his mother's stories about places like Ross's Point, its pilots, the metal man, and its fishermen. So that when he actually came to visit seaside homes like Elsinore, at Ross's Point itself, he was entering a well-prepared landscape of the imagination. The poet's grand-aunt, May Yeats, lived at Seaview Farmhouse overlooking storied Knocknarea across the channel. The aunt's garden, a dream of childhood that the future Nobel laureate would write about in Reveries Over Childhood, describing how he waited the blossoming of the gladiola flower. On the banks of the Rathbruhan River stands Fort Louis House, where lived the poet's great uncle Matthew Yeats and his large family of children, who used to sail toy boats on the river with Willie and Jack. To the budding genius of that far, far off youth, Sligo was, in truth, the land of heart's desire. Here a fairy child stole away a young bride to Knocknarea, bound up forever in Yeats's mind with the land of eternal youth. In his poetry, Yeats came again and again to Knocknarea Glen. In a cliff that's christened out, under a broken stone I bolt, at the bottom of a pit that broad moon has never lit. In his exile in London, the lakes and fancies of Sligo ever beckoned his imagination, begging him to come away, O human child, to the waters and the wild. To Innisfree or Loch Gill, where he set his most popular poem, the Lake Isle of Innisfree. I will arise and go now, and go to Innisfree, and a small cabin build there of clay and wattles made. 9 bean rows will I have there, a hive for the honey bee, and live alone in the bee-loud glade. Tor Ballylee, the old Norman tower that Yeats renovated and lived in from time to time, stands as sentinel to the poet's memory, a few miles from Gort in County Galway. Local craftsmen who lived and worked only a few yards away restored the tower for the poet. Yeats himself died in southern France in 1939, leaving both testimony and poetic instruction about where he was to be buried. Under bare Ben Bulbin's head, in Drumcliff churchyard, Yeats is laid. By his command, these words are cut. Cast a cold eye on life, on death. Horseman, pass by.